In preparing for planting my tomatoes, I have my hoe here. And this is my, I've been having this hoe for a long time. It's been with me for many years. My favorite hoe. My only hoe. H-O-E. And I'm going to take it, and I'm going to get my my trusty old file here, and I'm just going to go all along here. Yeah, and I'm going to just sharpen it up as best I can until I get a blade. So then I can go over there, and then I can just slice through all those weeds, and then I'll be ready to plant. All right. All right, so there it is. A good sharp edge is what you need. And let me flip it over. I'm going to cut the camera off and flip it over.
There you go.
So you got to sharpen both sides. Now I'm ready to get to it. Get to chopping. Slicing the weeds. Over there. All right, so I pretty much got it. Hold, I just need to rake the stuff up and put it on a compost pile. For this part of the operation, I'm going to use my bucket here, my 5-gallon bucket, and my gigantic hands and my expandable leaf rake here. If I can get it to expand. Oh, you got to push. Damn, technical difficulty. All right, it was just a bit rusty, that's all. But there it is. It's a pretty cool little deal there. Collapsible rake. And an extra pair of hands here. There you go. And I can just grab the stuff and put it in that bucket. Let's try to use your imagination there. I got a bucket load for the compost pile. Might have to go back over it again and hold a little bit more. But it doesn't have to be, you know, perfectly clean. I mean, the weed's going to continue to grow no matter what, you know. So let me head off to the compost pile and then pick up the rest of this stuff. Okay, I've been kind of hoeing here. You can see the soil is pretty loose. I mean, it doesn't take much. You know, I can do it with one hand, you know. Just like that, you know. It's kind of... Having a good sharp edge here makes it real easy. I mean, you can just tap it. See how loose that is? I'll show you right here. Look at that. I mean, it just goes right in. Pretty cool, huh? Well, let me finish. And there it is. It didn't take them on about maybe 10 minutes, maybe less. Just to kind of loosen up the soil a bit. Let it catch a little air. And then I'm gonna come back with my rake and kind of smooth it out a little bit. It doesn't have to be that smooth. Then I can plant my tomatoes and bell peppers. Okay, I'm getting ready to go outside here, so continue with my gardening here. I'm gonna get some of this. Oh, that's a big hole deal here. Osmocote coat, and I'm going to use that to sort of sprinkle around fertilizer. It's like it lasts about 3 months. It's a time release fertilizer, so it's a good idea to read the instructions, because you can put too much of this stuff and you know you're just going to get, I've done that already, and you get a whole lot of growth and you don't get any tomatoes. So it says basically tomatoes and peppers, I don't know if you can see this, 1 1/3 capfuls per 4 square feet. So what I have over here is I have 4 by 8. 4 by 8 is 32, 32 square feet. And, well, that comes out to 8 capfuls. I don't know if I'm going to just do it that way. I think I'm just gonna go, you know, like when you're seasoning your meat and stuff like that, I'm just gonna sprinkle it on there. So that's how I'm gonna handle that. All right, I've started sprinkling. See, I'm just gonna sprinkle it and season it up, you know, like season it up pretty good. Yeah. There we go. Give it a good seasoning. See that pole there? That pole is where I have electricity running under there. So I don't want to do like I did with the water over there when I broke the pipe. All right. Give it a good seasoning here. Yeah, I would say that's about maybe about 4 capfuls, maybe not quite. Let's go around one more time. We're gonna get it now. It has a smell to it. I can actually smell it. It has a chemical smell. I would prefer organic, but this is good. That ought to be good enough. Yeah, I don't want to overdo it. So that's how you do it. All right. So we got it all fertilized. Now I just need to go get my rake. All right, I got my rake. You know, I can't really rake one-handed, but, you know, just to give you an idea, I'm just going to rake it in. You know, just kind of rake it all in, sort of like that. So I'm going to continue to do that all over, and then kind of just rake it smooth, you know, just get all of the fertilizer mixed in. And, I mean, it doesn't have to be really smooth, you know, and fine and everything. I mean, it's just dirt, you know. I mean, they're gonna grow in it. I mean, even if I would leave it like this, you know, all lumpy and everything. Got the soil all raked, pretty smooth. Fertilizer in there, and my plants. See, the wind has gotten high there. And my trowel. It's a little bench to sit on. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna like just kind of figure out where I want to put the plants. Spread them out. Then I'm gonna just come back and sit out and put them in, and then I'm gonna water them in. Simple as that. All right, so one thing though that I want you to know is that you see this, you gotta take this off here. You know, you just kinda take that off the outside there. So that's the first thing I'm gonna do. I'm gonna sit down here. Just kind of peel that off because, you know, if it gets above the ground, it'll wick off the moisture. So it's just something I learned from watching PBS gardening shows and that kind of stuff. Then another thing I'm going to do is I'm going to break off these bottom leaves here. I just pinch them off. See. And that way I can bury the plant deeper, you know, so when it's dry, it'll be able to, it'll be deeper in the ground and it can get more, you know, that deep moisture, you know. All right, so what I've done is I've figured out where I want to plant them, and I pinched off bottom leaves, and I've taken off this peat right here, the edges, and I have them lined up. And I'm just gonna take my trowel and dig a deep hole and put them in. Simple as that. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, so I've got the hole dug and basically just fill the soil in around. See? Like that. You can get your hands dirty there. And then that's pretty much it. You can maybe make a little thing to hold the water if you want. Like around here. Make a little dam there. Pack them in like that, see? Pretty much. Yeah, you can make a little round deal there to catch the water if you want to do that. You don't have to. You can see I got them in pretty deep. Got a deep hole there. It could be deeper too. I really just, I love the feel of the dirt. There you go. That one could have been a little deeper there. Okay, these are better boy tomatoes. Anyway, you see I got 2 of them in already. And I just gotta get the other 2. Yeah, I got my plants in. They're not perfect. I think these are a little bit closer. I had to move that one over some. It could be a little deeper, but it's not even an exact thing, you know. Now, the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take these marigolds. Now, when I went there, don't tell the people at Walmart, but they had some bad plants in here. So what I did is I took the good plants out, and I just traded them and stuck them in here. So I got the best. They only had 3 6-packs left, and so I figured they, you know, they each had some good plants. So I wanted all good plants, so I just swapped out some in here. And I put the ones that weren't that good in the other 6-pack. So let me place them, and then we'll see what happens. All right, so I got them spaced out, pretty much. And they say that marigolds, because of the smell they have sort of a funky smell, that the insects don't like them. I don't know how true that is, but I know that I planted something like this last year, and they made all the way into the fall, and they just really were pretty. So that's why I decided to go with it this year. So I'm going to get down here and get down and dirty. All right, I just got my last marigold in. And there's everything all planted. Now, we have creatures back here. We have various beasts like possums and armadillos, and even dogs get back here, and cats. And cats like to use this for a giant litter box, and the armadillos like to dig it up. So I can't just leave it like that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to water them, and then I'm going to put some stuff over there, some wire and stuff to protect them. All right? So the next step is to water. Water them in. You want to give them a good start. Now, sometimes you can use a little Miracle-Gro to get them started, but I'm just going to use my plain old water here for my watering can. There you go. Drink it up, baby. And here we go. Here, give them a good, nice watering there. Put it in the frame. So what's next? They're tall enough to be staked. So I'm gonna go get some of those things I bought, tomato cages. I have them somewhere, so hold on, let me go get them. Yeah, I managed to get them in. I had to fight with some of them. Yeah, it's kind of crooked there, but it ain't about it being that beautiful, because when the plants grow, they're gonna cover all that anyway. And I wanted to get them firmly in, you know. This is what I'm using. Look how long. See how tall it is. See? So that's how deep I put it in. See? About a foot, maybe 18 inches. I mean, I have it up to... Found some wire fencing that I had years ago from back in the 80s. Discourage the animals from getting in there, and I'm not gonna worry about that side too much, but mainly this big open area here. And one more thing I want to do, my wife gave me this Dad's garden, and we gotta put it right there, and that's the beginning of Dad's garden 2012.